सर्वे नमः नमयों विष्णुपदाय कृष्णपृष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्तिवेदान्तस्वामिनीति नामिने नमस्ते सरस्वती देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेष शून्यवादी पाश्चात्यदेशसारिणे हे कृष्णा करुणा सिंधु दीनबंधु जगतपते गोपेश गोपिकाकांत राधाकांत नमस्ते सप्तकांचन गौरंगी राधे वृंदावनेश्वरी वृषभानुसुते देवी प्रणमामि हरिप्रिये नमो महावदन्नाय कृष्ण प्रेम प्रदायते कृष्णाय कृष्ण चैतन्य नामने गौरतीश नमः निलाचल निवासाय नित्याय परमात्मने बलभद्र सुभद्राभ्यं जगन्नाथाय ते नमः पंचाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपा सिन्धुभ्य एव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौरभक्तवृंद हरे कृष्णा कृष्ण कृष्ण हरे 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 राम 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 हरे 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 कृष्णा सो वेलकम ऑल ऑफ यू द मंथ ऑफ कार्तिक इज ऑन एंड वी आर ऑल सेलिब्रेटिंग वंडरफुल फेस्टिवल फ्यू डेज बिफोर वी हैड अ ग्रैंड फेस्टिवल ऑफ गोवर्धन टुडे इज गोपाष्टमी गोष्ठाष्टमी सो मेनी आचार्यस डिसअपीयरेंस एंड अपीयरेंस डेज एंड टुडे वी डिड प्रे फॉर ऑल ऑफ यू to the deities for your spiritual upliftment and everything and I'm very happy to see all of you only few are the videos are on but still I know all of you are there so we will start the third chapter and last week our Prabhuji took the first loka so we will be doing the second one the Bhagavad Gita as it is karma yoga Text number 2. This is Arjuna is speaking. Bhami Shrena Eva Vakyena Buddhim Mahayashiva Me Tad Ekam Vada Nischintya Yena Shriha Aham Aplutam. So Krishna, Arjuna is saying to Krishna, My intelligence is bewildered by your equivocal instructions. Therefore, please tell me decisively which will be most beneficial for me. Purport by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada. In the previous chapter, as the prelude of the Bhagavad Gita, many different paths were explained. Such as Sankhya Yoga, Buddhi Yoga, control of the senses by intelligence, work without fruitive desires, and the position of the neophyte. This was all presented unsystematically. A more organized outline of the path would be necessary for action and understanding. Arjun, therefore, wanted to clear up this apparently confusing matters so that any common man could accept them without misinterpretation. Very important, please hear carefully. Although Krishna had no intention to confusing Arjun by any jugglery of words, Arjun could not follow the process of Krishna consciousness either by interior or by active service. In other words, by his questions, He is clearing the path of Krishna consciousness for all students who seriously want to understand the mystery of the Bhagavad Gita. Ukham karoti vachalam pangur langayati grim jatpipatam aham bandhi paramananda madhavam shri chetandeshwaram shri guru dinotarinam. So here, as we all know, that what is happening, Arjun is asking question to Krishna. Till now, different yoga practices has been described by Krishna himself. And Arjun being confused, you know, he was confused by seeing his near and dear ones and Krishna starts speaking. As Krishna says, different yogas, Sankhya Yoga, Buddhi Yoga, and so many yogas in a short period of time. Only this is third chapter. We have to go till 18 chapters. So Krishna tells Arjun in a summary that this is that, and you have to do this, you have to do that. Krishna is teaching through Arjun to all of us. And this is very clear to Arjun as well. So here Arjun is asking all these questions to Krishna because Arjun knows this Bhagavad Gita is going to be read throughout the world. As long as the human race is there, as long as humans, they want to be happy in their life, they will take shelter of Bhagavad Gita. And that is the reason in Gita Mahatva, it has been very nicely discussed that Sarva Upanishadho Gabho Dugdha Gopala Nandana Partha Vatsa Sudhir Bhokta Pivam Gita Amrita Mahat. So if we consider all the scriptures, Upanishads, as a cow, Krishna is milking that cow, and the milk itself is Bhagavad Gita. And who is drinking that milk? There are three persons actually are supposed to drink that milk. First personality is Arjun, Partha, Vatsa Sudhir Bhokta. Partha is a personality, he is drinking that milk and Krishna is milking. And Sudhi, Sudhi means those who are hearing Bhagavad Gita, like all of us, all of you who are hearing Bhagavad Gita. Partha Vatsa Sudhir Bhokta and the Vatsa, Vatsa is actually Partha and all of us we are hearing. So cow, today is Gomata's Gopashtami, Goshthashtami. So as a mother cow feeds milk to the calf, similarly the calf here is Arjun. And we are also hearing through Arjun. So Arjun got bewildered. And his bewilderment happened because he was very much attentive whatever Krishna is speaking. Please mark it. Please understand it very nicely. We sometimes hear spiritual talks because we like it. We like it, you know, we enjoy it. But actually, Arjuna's condition was not like any other person. Arjun was in a deep problem. The world war was about to be started. And then conch were blown from both the sides. At that time, Krishna took, because Arjun wanted to see who have come for fighting. Pashyatam Panduputranam Acharjam Mahatam Chumam. So Krishna took the chariot in between the two armies in front of Kuru army, where Arjun's most beloved personalities were standing, headed by Bhishma Pitamaha, Dronacharya, Kripacharya, and so forth. By seeing them, he becomes, you know, bewildered. Karpanya dosa pahata svabhava prichhami tang dharma samudra chetah jasreya sannischitang bhuyatan me shishyasya angshadi mangtang prapanyam. He says that till now I was thinking you are my friend. Yes, you are my friend. However, at this time I understand I have to accept you as my spiritual master or guru or teacher. So when he starts accepting Krishna, unless and until we also accept our personality whom we will listen, actually our spiritual life will never start. It's the same thing that, you know, Prabhupada many times mentions. You need a teacher. In every sphere of life, we need a teacher. You may be teaching your kids, you may be teaching your students, you may be teaching spiritual talks. But unless and until we also become a good student, you cannot be a good teacher actually. So we have to listen. So it is stated that when we speak, we repeat what we know. But when we hear, then we learn something new. Isn't it nice? When we speak, we just repeating what we know. And sometimes, you know what happens? Because of the ego. You know what is ego? All of us, we know what is ego. Ego means prakriti kriyamanani gunai karmani sarvasah ahankara vimudatma karta aham iti manyate. Ego means I know everything. And that is the problem of this material world. As long as we think that we know everything, actually, we will never know anything. That is the reason there is a story that once one two students who are very eager to learn how to play mridanga, they went to one teacher. The teacher asked to the first boy, "You know something?" He said that, "I don't know anything about mridanga." Then the teacher said, "Okay, well, very good. So I will charge you 200 rupees per hour. That is your dakshina." Okay. Then he asked the second boy, "Do you know anything about mridanga?" He said, "Yes, yes, yes. I know this, I know that, but still I want to continue with you." Then the teacher said, "For you, it is 500 rupees per hour." Then he got bewildered that he does not know anything. You are charging 200 per hour. Now I know certain things. Why you are charging 500 rupees per hour? Why 300 rupees more? This is injustice. Because I already know." Then the teacher said, "What you know is actually bogus. So make you forget whatever you have learned, which is wrong. I need to give more labor." Now he is just like a slate without any scratch. Because of that, whatever I teach him from the very beginning of the day, he will learn very quickly. But for you, because you think you know, to make you understand that you don't know certain things, to make you forget those wrong things which you have been taught, I am charging more. Similarly, this, you know, place where what the acharyas are saying, Arjun was very clear actually. Arjun was asking humbly to Krishna that, "My dear Lord, you please help me to understand whatever you have told till now. I'm getting puzzled. Which one I have to do? Which one I have to follow?" Similarly, this shloka teaches all of us actually three things. First, we need to be submissive in our spiritual life. And we must accept a person whom we must have faith. And with faith and love and affection, we understand what he is teaching. Secondly, we should not be proud, or we should not be, feeling that I know everything. You see, Arjun was a person who can control the wind. He was not an ordinary person, you know, in this material world. He went to Swarga. Even Mahadev personally, you know, gave him a lot of arrows and blessings. He is actually, he's very powerful. He can bring fire, he can stop fire, he can bring wind, he can control the wind, everything. But still you see his mood is so beautiful, which Krishna says, "Tadviddhi pranipatena pariprashtena sevaya upadekshanti te jnanam jnaninam satya darshina." Unless and until we have complete faith and surrender ourselves to the teacher, the knowledge won't flow. And the third thing what we can learn is, if we don't understand certain things, we need to ask question. Even Srimad Bhagavatam also, it has been stated, athato brahma jigyasa. Everything starts with a question, but how to ask that question? With humility, with submissiveness, and with the mood of service and mood of love. When one person is humble, then the mercy flows. Spirituality or divinity flows from up to down. If we try to snatch it, then we will be not successful. You won't be happy actually. Sometimes, you know, in this material world it happens. You know, there is a competition. Who will take that post? Who will crack the interview? But in the spiritual world, it is nothing like that. Spiritual world means we submissively try our level best to be surrendered. Trinadapi suni chena taror eva sahishnuna amanina manadena kirtaniya sadahari. This is the mood of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, who is Krishna himself. He is teaching all of us that if you want to be a devotee of Krishna, if you want to be a Vaishnava or Vaishnavi, so you need to be humble like grass. You have to be tolerant like tree. And you need to give respect to those even without expecting any respect from them. In this way, we come. This is the way that, you know, we achieve Krishna's mercy. See, there is some doubt. We need to be clear. We need to clear that. That is very nice. Then second thing, we should not think, as I discussed, that we should not think that I know everything. If you know everything, then you will be sarvagya jana. Sarvagya jana in Bengali? Sarvagya jana means I know everything. No, then if you know everything, then you will be Krishna. But Krishna says, aham ekam evam adityam. I am one and without a second. He is the only Supreme Personality of Godhead. He knows everything. Vartaman bhuta bhavishya. We don't know what is going to happen tomorrow morning. Sometimes I ask the kitchen, hey, what you are making tomorrow in breakfast? So they said, okay, Prabhu, we are making khichdi and papadam. And then when you go to the kitchen, you see that it is poha, means chuchura. And I said, what happened? Material world, Prabhu, things changing. Hare Krishna. So what to do? So you cannot tell what is happening next. So how can you know, tell that I know everything? However, because of the ego that we carry in ourselves, and when we come to this material world by the touch of these three gunas, urdham gacchati sattvata madhye tishtha rajasa jaganna guna vrittasya adho gacchanti tamasa, what happens actually, we get entrapped with these three modes of material nature. Prakita kyo manani gunai karvani sarvasa, these gunas, they make us feel that I know everything, and then the problem starts. So Arjun is very submissively asking here, please let me know, I'm getting bewildered. And then the first one, what I said, that you need to, we all need to understand, we need a teacher. So first we need to understand, I need a teacher. You know what is the solution of problem? What is the solution of problem? How many of you can tell? If there is a problem, how you can solve it? Anyone? Any problem? How you can solve the problem? Okay, I will tell you. First, we need to accept that there is a problem. First, we need to accept that there is a problem. Sometimes people come and tell, na, that Dada, you have this problem, you did this, but we don't accept. No, I didn't do this. I have my arguments. How I am right and he is wrong. Sometimes some person comes and some person tells that, you know, you should have done this, but you did this. Then I have my arguments, you have your arguments. So sometimes there is problem, but we don't accept there is a problem. So the Lord says to Arjun that, Arjun, yes, I will help you. And then, you know, we will see in third chapter how beautifully things goes. The spiritual life means, spiritual life means that we need to understand we don't know everything. There are four categories of listeners according to the scripture. Very interesting. Who can listen nicely? Who are the four categories of audience, maybe? Or, you know, audience, the four categories of audience. The first audience is just like a crow. Crow means kawa, ka, ka, you know, kawa. So kawa will always take, you know, that sort of audience will always take from the speaker, the whole speech you have given, they will take only whatever is the negativity he has spoken. Any negative thing is that he will take that one on. So that is the one type of audience who always, or listener who take only negative thing. Then second types of audience is a very strange audience. You know, they are just like, you know, you know, what do you call, the fox. They will take just like a fox, you know. If you say, tell something that, you know, this is something like that. Oh, I know. Oh, yes, I know. Hum jante hain, jante hain. Yes, look, hai na, aha, main bataya na, main janta hoon. Are, wo kya batayenge, main hi bata deta hoon. Falana, 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 falana. So they're just like, you know, what do you call, foxes. They sometimes, aha, no, they make sound. Oh, oh. So foxes makes a sound. So similarly, some audience will be there. They will be thinking that I know everything. They will make sound. Then crow, and then fox, and then there is another personality, who just like a frog, you know. They will just sit down and they will not understand what is happening actually. Is kaan se ghusa ke dusre kaan se nikal dein. From this ear, they will put something and then another person will go. The best one is a swan. Swan means Hamsa. You know, Hamsa means, you know, swan. All of you know swan, right? Raj Hamsa. If you give milk and water mixed together to a swan, immediately he will take only the milk portion and the watery things he will be making aside. Similarly, the best listeners, the person who are coming to hear with attentiveness, and they will take only whatever is needed for their life, whatever is very much important from our, you know, for us, they will take that much, and rest they will keep it aside. So here, very beautifully, Arjun is, you know, asking question to the Lord, that my dear Lord, can you make it very easy for me to understand? It's very simplicity of Arjun. Arjun is not trying to understand things in his parameter, in his understanding. No, he wants to hear it from the Lord. This is another one thing that we need to understand. Unless and until it is coming from parampara, unless and until it is coming from the bona fide authorities who have been practicing it and realized souls, it is very difficult to understand what the Lord is saying. So Arjun never wanted to concoct anything, or he does not wanted to speculate anything. And that is the reason also Arjun is asking Krishna, you please tell me what to do and how to go ahead. Whatever you have spoken, can you make it more simpler for me? It is Krishna's simplicity, is Arjuna's simplicity. And beside that also, he knows that when Krishna speaks it very clear, whoever will be hearing Bhagavad Gita, they will be not confused. They will be always clear from their mind. And this happens when one person is very humble. One person who is very honest. And that is the reason, if you read, you know, the next chapter, you know, next loka, Arjun has been called by Krishna as the sinless Arjun. You know, you are very pure. Krishna is saying, you are very pure. Because Krishna knew that Arjun is very pure, that is another reason why Krishna is speaking this Bhagavad Gita's whole knowledge to him directly. So these principles of Krishna consciousness, not only in our life, in our spiritual life, in our material life also, if you use, then we will be a very, very good student. Arjuna is being a very good student, these things he has accepted. He has accepted an authority. He is submissively, very beautifully, without any challenge, he is requesting the Lord to help and make it clear. He is very conscious that nobody should misinterpret Krishna's, you know, words. So he is trying to clarify it from Krishna. And ultimately, he is doing it because he knows that time, immortal, this knowledge of Bhagavad Gita, Maline mochanam pumsam jalasnanam dine dine sakrubhritamrita snanam sangsara malanashanam. You know, this knowledge of Bhagavad Gita will be spread throughout the world. everywhere because it is Krishna's, you know, song of God. So these are the things that Krishna is speaking. In Bhagavad Gita, and Arjuna is asking, this dialogue between two friends are the most attractive dialogues ever happened even in between two friends. In recent time, there was survey. There was a survey made throughout the world. What is the best dialogue, you know, between two friends? And then India offered the best dialogue ever happened, Haribol, in between two personalities, two friends, and that is Bhagavad Gita. Because when we speak, I don't know what comes out. especially in addas, whenever we meet, actually, you don't know what comes out. However, when Krishna and Krishna's friend spoke, you see, every Friday we are hearing the same conversation because it is life-giving. In the same way, we need to also apply those things in our life. Then that will be the biggest justice that we can do towards ourselves and towards Krishna also. Krishna is very kind. This Bhagavad Gita is nothing but Krishna's compassion, Krishna's love, Krishna's care, Krishna's protection, Krishna's, a biggest gift towards us, towards his devotee. He cannot tolerate his devotee's little bit of pain. You know, sometimes many people come to the temple, and sometimes, we stay in the temple, and we need to little bit extend. Sometimes some of you also come, Prabhu, we are coming, are you there? And sometimes you just come and appear in front, you know, and maybe, you know, I'm going for somewhere else. But then when you come, because of my respect towards you all and my love towards you all, I have to extend myself. I'm just giving an example. And then, you know, being a mortal human being, we get tired. And that makes me sometimes be a little technically official. And I say that, well, if you want to talk to me, if you want to meet me, come, you know, this time, that time, and, you know, pre-book me. Though I am not traveling because of the COVID, but soon, Krishna willing, we will start traveling. But you see, Krishna is so kind, so loving, so affectionate. He is not saying, Arjun, why you're asking this question? I told you already. You're a stupid or what? Why not understanding? Itna kuch bola, sab bhul gaya. Ab simple, kitna simple hoga, hai? No, he's not saying that. He is very mercifully, he is saying, oh, the sinless one. He is encouraging the student. He is showing his compassion. That is the position of Jagannath. That is the position of Krishna. And we all need to understand the blessing that we are having. We have our spiritual life. We have our Hare Krishna Mahamantra chanting. We have our deities, Radha Govinda, Sriman Mahaprabhu, Jagannath, Baladev, Subhadra, Mani, Sudarshan. And in all the cities and all the countries, you have temples. We have devotees association. We have dhams, Vrindavan, Puri, even Calcutta, Prabhupada's place, and Shivadham Mayapur. So sometimes what happens actually, you know, we don't understand how much blessing we are in. And we neglect that. Just like a person who is in a, cake shop. Sometimes I go to my Govinda's restaurant and there are lots of pastries, lots of cakes. Yummy, I know. Many of your mouths are maybe watering. And then samosa, kachori. Ah, haribol. So So when you go inside, you know, you get beautiful aroma, you know, aroma of the, you know, but those who are staying inside, they don't get that because they are habituated. They are getting every time. When you open the door, Mahaprasad, Arival. Similarly, sometimes it happens to us. We don't understand the blessing that is flowing upon us. This is the month of Kartik. We know that we have to offer lamb. There's a month of Srimati Radharani, month of Yashoda. There's a month of Ramchandra's coming back. And how fortunate we are to have the spiritual family like this and hearing Krishna Katha weekly. This is our strength. This is our respect for Krishna. And when we understand that, how you prove that you are understanding that? By implementing all the teachings that Arjuna is giving here, Krishna is giving here in our life. And then it will be, we will be all happy. We will be internally happy. Sometimes, you know, externally we are happy, but face is the mirror. You can't hide. But if you're internally happy, without any cosmetics, you glow. When people say, these devotees, they glow. Prabhupada, when he started this Nagar Sankirtan, devotees were chanting, Hari Bol, Hari Bol, Hari Bol, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. And then everybody was saying, these devotees, they glow. Why? Because by chanting Hare Krishna Maha Mantra, by worshipping and serving the deities, by reading Srimad Bhagavatam and Bhagavad Gita and spiritual scriptures, by offering respect to Vaishnavas association, and by performing devotional service in the spiritual lands, you know what has happened? Their heart has become very soft like butter and very pure like butter. And then Krishna has stolen that. Why Krishna steals butter? Because butter is pure and butter is soft. So unless and until our heart becomes soft and our heart becomes pure, how Krishna will steal that? Krishna will pinch that heart and say, abhi bhi kadak hai. Oh no, it is little hard. It needs to be little more softer. So how to make it soft? By this process of Krishna consciousness, which Arjuna is teaching all of us. If we have some doubt, ask question. How to ask question? With humility. What is the intention of the question? To clear. You need to ask question which is beneficial for everyone and for yourself. Sometimes people ask some questions which do not have any meaning. Radharani, why does not she wear tilak? How does it matter to you? What is the name of Jagai Madai's father and mother? How does it matter to you? These are all, you know, crazy questions. It may come, but it is how it is going to benefit anyone. But sometimes we ask questions to show, well, I asked one question and the person was unable to answer it. What's the use? So Sukadeva Goswami and Krishna himself in Bhagavad Gita is praising Krishna. That, the sinless one, the person who does not have any envy about anyone. And then the ultimate thing, why we need to ask questions? Because we need to get this clear through the Lord and the parampara, where all the people will be away from any misconception and concoction. Everything needs to be clear. Thank you very much.